Previously on Arrow.
Does Vinny need someone to stand up who isn't hiding behind the mask? It needs a leader. So, I decided to run from there.
Holly, this is Alex Chavis, the new political strategist that Wilt's recommended.
At the hospital, Sarah Niels. She wasn't there.
But I'm the one who killed her in the first place. Why is she after me, you know? It's bloodlust. She's consumed by it. It's the same pain I feel when I think about her loss. If she kills me, she'll be okay.
There's more to record it. Something overlapping with her.
What I need to know is,
open your file. Atom Project. Update again.
This will be miniaturization test number one. Excellent. I can't even hear it the first try. It's been a long haul figuring out your platform, but the good news is we're almost done. Just two more things are on the docket.
Actually, only one. I figured out where we're going to hold all these fundraisers. It's going to be at Gerard's.
From what I remember, that place is a little pricey, leading us to our last talking point, the budget. Yeah, right?
Mm-hmm.
If by you mean Felicity, then yes. She was supposed to be here, but she's just been slammed at Palmer Tech for the past few days.
She's really taking this whole CEO thing seriously.
Well, one of us has to have a job that actually makes money. I'll speak with her. I'll get those numbers for you. Alex, thank you so much for all your hard work.
See you later.
I was thinking maybe we should check out Gerard's tomorrow night. You know, just make sure it's the right type of venue for introducing our candidate.
Are you asking me out on a date?
To be honest, it's been so long, I don't even know.
I just, my life's pretty complicated right now. And I don't think going on a date with my brother's campaign manager is going to make it any easier.
Oh, you're right. That was totally unprofessional. Something I normally never do. I just thought there was something there. Probably just consumed a little too much MSG. How about we just erase it for the last 5 minutes?
Absolutely not. It was nice.
See you later.
I'm alive. And I'm in trouble. I'm alive. And I'm in trouble. I'm alive.
I thought I said you could use my lab if you clean up after yourself.
The keyword being after, which assumes finished, which clearly I am not.
Well, how's it going? That well. Do you have that plan on a loop?
I've been trying to trace Ray's message back to its point of origin, but he must have ping-ponged it off of like 1,000 servers, and the backtrace algorithm won't compile, which means there's no way of finding him, and...
Okay, you need to stop right now.
I can't.
You have to. You are no good to Mr. Palmer in your current state. Now, how long has it been since you took a break?
Did his offer about 2 minutes, about an hour ago? Does that count?
You're very straight,
Oliver Queen, Curtis Oliver.
Curtis, Felicity told me a lot about you.
She's told me virtually nothing about you.
Okay. Curtis, what you doing?
The Green Arrow showed up right about the time that you came back into town.
It's not you, though.
Got that right.
That's what I keep telling people.
Could you give us a minute?
Sure thing.
Nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you, too. Hey. I thought that you were going to come by the campaign offices to go over the finances.
I thought that meeting was on Wednesday.
It is Wednesday.
Oh.
What's going on?
I'm alive, and I'm in trouble.
That sounds like...
Ray. Because it is Ray. Because Ray isn't dead.
What? It's impossible. Ray was...
killed in an explosion that blew up the top of this building 6 months ago. But that's obviously not what happened because he sent this message 6 days ago, and dead people don't generally do that. Ray's alive. He's out there somewhere. I have to help him.
Why didn't you ever tell us about this place before?
I didn't know it was here. So it seems like you did.
I know this island isn't all that it seems. Done well, Mr. Queen.
You let the British guy get away.
Well, wait. Writer. Constantine said that there was some sort of barrier. Like magic.
No interest in the chamber.
What is that?
A message from the ancients. Leading to a very special gift. Heart of water. Have you seen a cove on the island? Surrounded by mountains?
I know one.
I want you to go to that point and lead an excavation. Take a dozen of the laborers and work them until you find my gift.
Hey, I'll talk to you for a sec.
All right, first, what aren't you telling me about what we're doing here? I mean, apart from everything.
And second...
Queen is a mole. We'll start trusting him just because he gave you a piece of land.
I come from Mr. Queen to the cove.
I know. I love you too, Mom. I love you so much. Okay, bye, Mom.
How'd that go?
Easier than the last time Mom found out that I wasn't dead.
You okay, honey?
Yeah, fine. It was just something Mom said about how I got lost when I was walking home from school once and how I promised that I'd always come back. I can't remember. You're probably better off not remembering all the messed up things our parents did to us anyway.
Now, you two turned out perfectly, right? More importantly, you're both home. I couldn't ask for anything more.
I tell you, Ray's in trouble, and your first response is you need a shower.
And a nap. You're not going to be able to help.
Oh, stop! You're starting to sound like Curtis.
And Curtis is a smart guy. Did Ray's message indicate what kind of trouble he's in?
If it did, it would have been the first thing I told you.
Okay. Is there anything that I can do to help?
Well, have you magically learned to code in the last 72 hours?
No.
That's a rhetorical question.
I know.
I will, however, accept your undying support and back row.
You can have both as soon as you
shower
and take a nap. Come on. Come on, come on. What?
I sent an alert just in case the bachelor's program ever finished compiling.
Listen to you.
I'm taking forever.
What are you doing?
Absolutely nothing.
What's taking
possession? Oh my God, Ray!
Ray, where are you?
I don't know. Enough. I'm being held against my will.
What?
They want my suit, or at least the tech. The only good news is the tech is useless to them in my current condition.
Ray, if you have your suit, then why don't you just...
Ask my way up. Yeah, that's not really happening.
But the suit doesn't work?
Actually, it worked a little too well.
Tater tot. Ray modified his suit with the same nanites I injected into him after Bad Arrow shot him. It's a long story involving a lot of molecular physics. The bottom line is that Ray jury-rigged a short-range message burst that was intercepted by whoever is holding him captive.
Ray thinks they want the suit for its technology, but they can't use it while it's small.
And while he's small, it's like looking for a needle in a city of haystacks. Ray has something he thinks could help.
Back up, Bomber Tech. I've got some nanites or a machine that should be able to recite me.
So you're both filled in.
Where are you going?
To Bomber Tech to pull up the schematics to Ray's device.
I'll come with you.
Why? Are you going to build the thing?
No. There must be some other way I can help.
There isn't.
This isn't over, you know. You and me.
I'm so glad.
Need to get a couple people in the water. Dive down. See what you can find.
Everyone is tired. We've been here for hours. If you want them to work, they have to be able to.
You their leader?
I'm the guy telling you to let them rest.
Okay.
We brought food. Take 15 minutes and eat.
Thank you, employer of the month.
I'm going to need you to keep an eye on them. And I'm going to go enjoy my lunch in peace.
Hey, Ukraine.
My name is Vlad.
Well,
Vlad.
How'd you like your life to get a little better?
Got miniaturization to work. He made the space between atoms shrink. I mean, this is like solving cohesion and ultimate theory. Do you have any idea how amazing this is?
Yes, but the fact that Ray is being held hostage and could be killed at any moment because he is the size of a Cheeto has dampened my enthusiasm somewhat. Can you build this?
Yes. All the materials are here at Palmer Tech, except for that. That is a quantum manifold.
Never heard of it. Where do we get one?
Only one place. The manufacturer. They hold a patent on it. Well, actually, 16 patents.
That is where?
Court Industries. I would ask them to do us a solid and loan it to us, but...
They're our biggest competitor.
The good news is, things can't get any worse.
You just had to look at it.
There you are!
What are you doing here?
Well, I went to your office, Miss CEO, and your assistant told me to be here, so... Here I am.
Not here, here. Star City. Here.
Well, Oliver told me that you've been working nonstop this past month, so I suggested a visit from your mom. It's exactly what you needed, and guess what?
What?
He agreed. Oh. Hi. And who are you? Oh.
Hi. I'm Curtis Holt. It is an absolute pleasure to meet you.
Oh.
I can see where Felicity got her,
Blonde hair.
Well, she dyes it, actually. What do you want to do first? Trip to the mall, Manny Petty. You know what? You must be exhausted from your flight. Why don't I get a car to take you back to my place? Car? No, baby, I came here to see you. I know, and you will. It's just that right now, Curtis and I are trying to figure out how to build a very important piece of equipment or someone could die. Die? Metaphorically speaking. You start constructing the machine, and I will get you the mask.
It's proprietary. How are you going to do that?
Awesome.
The Green Arrow's going to take his mask tonight.
If I don't take it first...
I thought it would be a good thing.
A good thing? What on earth made you agree to this?
Well, you know, your mom doesn't really take no for an answer.
You faced down Mira Kuru soldiers and the League of Assassins. Are you honestly telling me that you couldn't say no to my mom?
She said she missed you, and then she texted me one of those emojis with the single tear.
You have been texting with my mother? How long has that been going on?
You guys think we can find a better time to fight about this?
John, I thought only Oliver's line was open.
Nope, mine is open.
And mine.
Yeah. And everything was shatter on these missions. You okay? Yeah. I need a little longer. For me, the kind of thing that
passes. I hacked the security panel, but it needs to be accessed from the inside. Only problem is that the building's interior is protected by pressure-sensitive flooring, which means Chatty Cathy, you're up.
Chatty Cathy.
Your new code name, the only one appropriate enough I could think of to use in polite company. When the loading dock doors are open, you'll have 90 seconds to find the manifold and answer it before men with guns show up. Chatty Cathy?
No.
Something's wrong. The security cameras are coming back online.
I got it.
No, don't you understand? If Ford upgraded their security, they probably improved their response time. Late-night shopping at Cord Industries couldn't solve.
Oh, that's great.
Thank you for listening. Now we just have to figure out how to...
Ray, you still there? Oh, no. What happened out there?
Sarah, she, had a moment with the security guard.
Well, Dia took her home. Are you sure it was Dark that you saw in Ray's camp?
Just as sure as I am that Ray is not getting out of this.
It's actually good that Dark has Ray.
This would be the same level of delusion that made you think my mother coming to town would make me feel better.
Because it's Dark, that means that we have an asset.
Lance.
I'll ask him to get us a location.
And what if between then and now, Dark decides to squish Ray underneath his shoe?
If Dark wanted to hurt Ray, he would have done it by now.
Diggs right. We stay focused. We get Curse the manifold, keep him working, and we unfortunately just have to wait and see what Lance finds out.
I hate waiting and seeing. I have to do something.
Your mother's in town. Spend some time with her. We could do dinner. I'll cook.
You already made dinner plans for my mother, didn't you?
What? No. Yes.
Oh my God. It is like a sickness with you.
It wasn't intentional. We were having a nice conversation. The subject turned to cooking. I mentioned that I make a spectacular chicken cordon bleu. She said she never had one. It's just dinner.
He's right. Listen, besides, you look like you haven't eaten or slept.
A man's life, a friend's life is in danger. Doesn't seem like the right time for cordon bleu.
I promise you that there is nothing that we can do until we get what we need from Lance and Curtis. So dinner, 7 p.m. I'll be there as soon as I'm done with Lance. Nice instincts.
I wasn't sure you were coming back.
I said that I would.
I guess it seems like a nice thing, but I've lost faith in people doing what they said they're going to do.
Do you notice Ryder interested in anything other than the camp or drugs?
Yeah. He also enjoys stealing people away from their families.
Have you seen him do anything mystical or even magical?
He always has been a little odd, and very religious. He's even blessed some of the prisoners, claims he's healed their souls or some craziness.
I'm getting to think the drugs are just a front for what he's really doing here.
Must it be more tempting to a man like him than money?
Power. I can't say long. I can't have Conklin being any more suspicious of me than he already is, but we still need to stay here. I'll come back as much as I can.
This time, I believe you.
I thought it was past time we met. My engineers have had no success in restoring you to your proper size, so I thought it'd appeal to your cooperation.
And what do I get if I help you out? Apart from probably death.
No. I don't think it's your life I should be worried about. And who is this Felicity, I wonder? Certainly not your former vice president, current CEO, girlfriend.
Don't touch her.
Don't make empty threats. It's small. Oh, and by the way, we weren't listening for a distress call from a dead man. It was pure luck, really, that we intercepted your message. But isn't luck just another word for destiny?
Sorry, I'm late.
I tried following the recipe. You know, I think your oven might be broken because I was supposed to put it in for like 20 minutes and all of a sudden it just, I don't know, smoke just started billowing out. I think it was just a little slightly undercooked.
I think the technical term is raw.
It's fine. It's fine. I'm going now. I'll whip something up.
You just always fix everything.
Yeah, cool. I put a ring on that.
How'd that very important doctor's appointment go?
Good. Yes. Dr. Lance is just going to find out where the pain is coming from.
Pain? Are you okay, hon?
Fine. I'm just trying to figure out what I've done wrong.
I'm gonna go get some takeout.
Sorry, but I already made up some makeup sex.
Okay. Inviting your old mother for a surprise visit wasn't the best idea.
Yeah.
I totally accept that. What I'm not accepting or understanding, it's just you shutting me out.
I am not shutting you out. I'm trying to focus on finding Ray, but I can't do that with all of these distractions.
It's distraction? What is going on with you? You're acting like it's my fault that
it's
Ray...
It's my fault. What's happening with Ray to Ray is my fault.
Felicity, it really isn't.
Ray was sending distress calls for weeks after the accident. I wasn't here to receive them because I was too busy traveling the world with you. I took the police's word for it that nobody could be recovered because I was so swept up in being with you. I'm sorry. It was my choice to uproot my entire life, leave my home and my job, which turns out I'm very good at. I lost myself in you, and I was never that girl who just loses herself in a guy that is not who I am.
It isn't about Ray. It's about us.
No. Yes. I don't know.
I'm gonna give you some space to figure it out. The traffic cameras are online.
Yeah, you gotta get a minute to upload.
What are you doing here anyway? Thought I was waiting for Lance and you were having dinner with the smoke ladies. We thought, well, did it.
Do you know what I miss about our old space?
That trunk with a bottle of Russian vodka in it. Vodka is for wimps anyway. Tennessee whiskey. Put some hair on your chest. It's hard to imagine dinner with Felicity and her mother not going well.
Donna's not the problem. I am. Felicity says that she's lost herself in our relationship, which means that she doesn't know who she is, and that if we hadn't have left Star City when we did, she would have been around to help Ray.
Metahumans, magic, resurrections. Donna's seen it all, but Oliver Queen, jealous.
Not jealous. I just gotta know if Ivy Town was as good as it gets for us. Because we've come back here, everything has just gotten super complicated, and it just makes me wonder... Why did she choose me?
I've heard you say a lot of crazy things over the years, but that has to be the prize.
You know what I mean?
It takes me 10 minutes to log into this thing. Felicity does it in 2 seconds, and Ray probably invented it.
Yeah, probably right. Except Felicity didn't choose Ray. She chose you. Sure, she has a lot in common with Ray. But sometimes we'll just get a little paper and it works in real life. But if something happens to him, we don't get him back.
Felicity Smoke is one of the smartest, most badass women on the planet. She comes through this, she gave Ray back.
You seem pretty sure.
I married a woman just like that. Twice, Oliver. Twice. Look, my relationships have their ups and downs. Sometimes you give us some time. A little bit of space. This night, meeting with Dark and 20. You good?
Better. Thank you.
Meeting me. I know you're a busy man.
I am. But I may have found a way to make the city useful for once.
I don't understand.
Oh, you will. Everyone in the city will.
Well, maybe I could find out sooner than others. My daughter, Sarah, she's bad, but not all the way. Something about her is still a little off.
I assure you the relevance escapes me.
Well, I was thinking maybe if I could help you a little more, then maybe you could help me. You know your way around this man.
Mumbo jumbo. I'll consider it, Captain. This will be the last time you summon me.
Johnny just left us at Southbound Victoria Street.
Copy that. I've got eyes on.
Yeah? I brought you some hot milk.
I'm not 10, Mom.
I'll bring it back downstairs.
Wait. You went to all the trouble.
Do you remember when you were a little girl and I told you you couldn't go to space camp? You locked yourself in your room for 2 days.
To be fair,
it was space camp, but I told you I couldn't bear the thought of sending you away for 8 weeks. The truth was, hon, I couldn't afford it.
Why didn't you just tell me that?
Because I was embarrassed, you know, that I had no money, that I had no idea where your father was, and even if I did, he'd never paid a dime in child support anyway.
I'm sorry. I had no idea.
I put everything into your father. My love, my trust, my funny. My point is, you are not me. You are the CEO of a $1 billion company. And Oliver, he's not like your father, hon. He loves you. No one has ever looked at me the way he looks at you. He's wonderful.
In a million different ways. But that's the problem. It's too easy to lose myself in him.
That's how it's supposed to feel. When you love someone, believe it or not, he's lost himself in you. And you'll find yourself in each other. Just don't get in your own way. Don't ruin something that most people never get. Because if you do, trust me, you'll never find another guy that hot again who cooks.
He is definitely hiding something in there.
Lawton Building. Before the city went to crap, it was touted as the most secure building on the West Coast. Every access point is protected by a retinal scanner and a voice print. There's no way we're getting in there.
Not from the outside, at least. How's Curtis doing on the resizing device?
He said he could have something functional in an hour. I don't think we have that kind of time.
He's going to have to assemble it in the field.
Wait, with us? Are we sure we want to have your assistant in on this? My employee, actually. And I'm not sure our company health plan covers supernatural dismemberment.
We need him. And if Curtis can resize Ray on the inside, then we have another hand getting us all outside.
Then how about one more? I don't think that's a good idea. Well, I don't know what's going on with me, but I need to know that I can control this. Suit up.
as art.
Very nice.
Oops.
Leave us.
Ready.
Listen.
Ready.
I was
ready for
it,
Ruby.
I thought HR wanted a little bit more excitement from what's happened. This really isn't what I had in mind.
You were the one who said you wanted to help Ray and that you were an accomplished prince, Jack.
Oh, God, we do have too many hobbies.
All right, Spartan, let's do this.
Spartan?
We have a guest tonight.
All right, this indeed is security systems. Bill won't be able to communicate his opponent. You know, it is a shame that you won't live to see the new life that I breathed into the city. The new life that I breathed into this world.
You won't get the chance.
Need a camera here with me. And those cameras.
Need to draw power from somewhere. Rick.
Well, I don't know about that. But I have side enough to power up Mantis.
Dr. Palmer's duty is ready. If you don't mind my using the technical term. I wasn't big small, but then everything else was so big. The explosion of Palmer Tech tossed me into an abandoned construction site. The cockroaches were the size of golden retrievers. I'm not exaggerating.
I think we don't need to know that, really.
The entomologist in me was actually really fascinated. I mean, you can't appreciate the size of the mandibles until the...
Nope. I've heard enough. I have a thing against cockroaches, insects, and spiders, but especially cockroaches. Sorry, not everyone shares your enthusiasm for bugs.
But it is good to see the experience didn't change you.
Indeed. I got your medical tests back, and aside from a very noticeable iron deficiency, all your results are positive. There don't seem to be any side effects from the, microgrowth, I think.
Relieved to hear it.
So are we.
So, this guy who wanted to make me his lab rat, Damien Dark. He's the leader of an organization we believe to be known as Hive.
Oh, Inspector? So cool.
And terrible.
Be assured, Palmer, that if they wanted your tech, it wasn't for any good reason.
One other thing. They overheard my message to you.
I'm a possible target, I figured. I wouldn't be doing this if I couldn't handle being threatened by a supervillain every now and then. Come on, I'll take you home. I can catch up on all the latest at your company.
Actually, until I decide to come back from the dead, it's your company.
Great.
Maria told me that this was a side effect of the pit, and I thought that I could fight it. I couldn't stop myself. And the worst part of it was I felt better. Look, Sarah, controlling this, it's not going to come easy, okay? It's going to take you some time.
And how many bodies? Look, I respect the way that you could deal with this, Thea, but I need to handle this in a different way.
Different how?
Well, I owe you everything. And you gave me the greatest gift that anyone ever could. You gave me a second chance and the ability to start over. I think it's time that I really do that. Sarah, we just call you back.
Sarah, you don't have to leave. I know it doesn't seem possible right now, but you can have a normal life.
It's been a long time since my normal has ever been normal.
Like, I'll go visit Mom in Central City. And then somewhere, maybe a few somewhere, just until I figure things out.
If you're sure that that's what you want to do.
It's your life. And you have to do what makes you happy. I'm just really going to miss you.
I love you, sis. Always and forever.
I love you, too.
Hey.
Hi.
How'd it go with Ray?
Fine. Until I told him I sold his condo.
Before we...
You go first.
No. You.
I think we should. Clear the air. I want to thank you for helping save Ray. For being so understanding in the midst of my mini gargantuan freakout.
I'm sorry that I'm not the best listener. But all of this is just kind of me.
And me. I didn't exactly grow up with the best example of a normal, healthy relationship.
Line forms behind me. It's kind of amazing that we've made it this far.
We're gonna be fine.
You may be so sure.
Because we found ourselves in each other.
But she kicked me out of her apartment to finish a fight with the man I hope will become my future son-in-law. Okay, it's your turn.
Well, one of my daughters is leaving town after being back a whole 5 minutes.
Sounds like a reasonable drink.
I don't see any reason. But this is cut short. Quit.
Done.
When your brother comes in, could you have to sign these for me, please?
Yeah.
Are you okay?
Just a little stressed out. And maybe I need to get a drink.
It's a little early for a cocktail, but...
Not now. Later? With you at drunk?
But I thought you...
I just want to have a normal life. Maybe there it is.
Yeah, absolutely. I'll leave you here.
Dr. Palmer's life is a relay. It's premised on a power draw from our system, which results
just because I understand science doesn't mean I'm not bored by it. Bottom line for me.
We were able to recover some residue from Dr. Palmer's four-star alloy and use it to fashion into a power source.
Good.
Move your head.
Thank you.